If you're wondering what sidechaining is and how to use it on drums, vocals, and other sounds, this tutorial will show you why using sidechain compression can clear up your mix and even create a pumping sound. Stick around, I'll show you a few ways to use this mixing technique. Hey everyone, Jake from Transverse Audio here. First of all, sidechaining is more professionally known as sidechain compression, as its true way of doing this is through a compressor. And that's the first way I'll be showing you how to do this, and it's the one I recommend using. What this does is it will compress one sound whenever a trigger sound is present. This can be as short as a kick drum or as long as a phrase in your vocals, but really there's no limits to this. Now let's get into some of the ways you can be applying sidechain compression throughout your mix. The first way is by using a compressor, and is the most versatile way to sidechain sounds with different lengths. Not to mention, it's automated. Go to the mixer track of the sound you want to lower in volume and apply a compressor onto that. Then go over to the mixer track of the source you want to use to trigger the compressor and route it over to the track you want to duck in volume. Depending on whether or not you want a trigger to be heard, such as using a ghost kick, you can either use sidechain to this track, which will keep the sound still audible, or sidechain to this track only, which will silence the triggering sound, but will still activate the compressor whenever it is present. Now, over on the compressor, you're going to have to switch from the limiter to the compressor. Then, depending on the mixer track of the sound you're using to trigger the compressor, select it on the sidechain input option. To set up the sidechain to make a pumping sound, lower the threshold to anywhere below negative 30 dB. Next, you'll need to raise the ratio anything higher than 1.5. Taking it further, you can move on to the envelope and noise gate to further refine the way the compressor works. If you want to learn more about what all of the parameters do on a compressor, check out the card on the top right to find out how to use the rest, including the limiter. The next way to do this is a pretty dirty way of doing this, and it's through volume automation. This is really only practical for letting percussion or repetitive sounds through, or for a sound effect. If you want to let effects like reverb or delay tail off while ducking the sound, create an automation clip of the channel volume. If you want to completely silence the effects as well, automate the mixer track volume. Once you have these automation clips set up, you can go into the playlist and change the pattern of automation. The last way is probably the easiest for specific patterns of sidechaining and is done with gross beat. Once you have it on the mixer track you want to sidechain, go into the effect plugin and down to the sidechain option. You can take it further by changing the automation clip here if you wanted to make a different pattern or change the intensity. Sidechaining allows important elements in your mix to stand out while not sacrificing the volume of something else, especially if it's a leading element. I hope you enjoyed this video on how to use sidechain compression. If you did, don't forget to share this video and subscribe. As always, thanks for watching.